Hey, what is up? We are in the messy, messy warehouse, and I'm going over six things I sold last week. Why? Why do you care? Because in addition to looking out for these things and making some money, I sold, I don't know, probably a couple hundred bucks, 500 bucks. I made a lot of mistakes, and I could have made, I would guess, 20% more, 30% more. And I'm going to explain to you what I did wrong. So when you find these things and you sell them, you're not going to make the same mistakes I made.
Item number one was a antique store find. It was two vintage fishing reels, a Zebco 909, which is the nicer one, and a Abumatic 315. I sold these together in a lot. I auctioned them off, and they sold for 15 bucks plus shipping. All in all, it was about $23 sale price. Now, the Zebco 909, those sell for 30 bucks sometimes, 25 bucks alone. So I got less for the two of these than I would have by itself. The Abumatic 315 is a $10 reel. It's not very nice. What I should have done is done more research on that, sold that by itself for 10 bucks, and then auctioned off the Zebco 909. The issue is it's a chrome body reel, and there was some serious pitting on the chrome. Pitting is little holes on the surface of it. Looks kind of like orange skin. Little pores from who knows what, corrosion, decay, all that bad stuff. And what I should have done probably is taken a better picture of the Zebco 909. I showed it functions fine, but it's not exactly the most clean reel. And so definitely, if you have anything old and chrome, I would check out to see what condition it is in specifically, because old chrome stuff, and I know this sounds like obvious advice, but old chrome stuff, it varies so drastically from a bad item condition, a bad condition item, to a good condition item. You really want to make sure that you are doing your due diligence. And also remember, sometimes putting in more things to an auction can actually lower the price. If one of the items is so low value that they actually don't want it. I made a mistake thinking the person who would buy this is a collector. No, they're not. They use them. And they don't want the shitty Abumatic 315. And if I'm saying it wrong, I don't know how I could be. But if I am, just keep it to yourself, okay? I'm kidding. Tell me how to say it, and I'll say it right the next time. All right, next up is a fun one. It is the kind of thing that I like to auction off. It was three pairs of busted up Jordans. I don't know, an 11, a 13, and a 9, I think. They give them numbers. One of them may have been a bootleg. I'm not sure. They were all in such disrepair. The toe was falling off, the soles were worn out, that I knew I couldn't sell them by themselves for much more than 10 or 15 bucks, and with shipping, that just devours it. So what I did is I put them all together. They're all close to the same size. And I said, okay, I'm gonna auction these off. I started at 99 cents, and they ended up selling for about 55 bucks with shipping. I did shipping additionally. So it was 41 plus like $17 shipping. They went across the country to California. The guy is gonna repair them and sell them, or maybe wear them. Who knows? It's the kind of thing where individually, I definitely could not have got more money for these, but together, they did okay. What I did wrong on these is probably I should have put more shoes in there. I was just over, or with those three pairs of shoes, it was just too big to cram into a flat rate box, and it was going across the country. And so probably I could have been a bit smarter about shipping those and added more, because once you hit like the 3 pound range, 3 to 10 pounds with shoes, volumetrically, is not that much of a difference if you wrap them the right way and ship them the right way. So probably I was on the lower end of what a lot should be for a resale lot like that or a repair lot like that. Not the worst mistake in the world, but just something to think about. A Sony Explode. I sold this on Mercari. Why Mercari? If you follow my channel, you know I sell Sony on Amazon all the time. I've been selling for a long time, and luckily I'm ungated for Sony, so I make a bunch of money doing that. So why would I choose to sell this Sony item on Mercari? Well, because it was in bad condition. I probably shouldn't have bought it. I paid 10 bucks for it. I sold it for 44, and so after shipping, I more than doubled my money, shipping and fees, on Mercari. So that was awesome, but the top was all scratched up. The antenna had been snapped off, and I was worried that if I sold it on Amazon, I could have got probably $85 to $100 for it, but I risked the return, and I don't want to endanger my Sony status at all. I'm not saying one return's going to do that if you're ungated, but, you know, why not err on the side of caution if it's only going to cost you, you know, well, potentially save you money. Why not? So anyways, Mercari, it took 2 months to sell. A month and a half to sell. Went to Texas. Nothing too fancy, but I did double my money, so that was good. On to Amazon. Amazon FBA. I sold Technosource Illuminated Mega Sudoku Puzzle Game to a nice man in Livingston, New Jersey. I sold this for, with tax, almost $64. What I got before fees was $60. So, you know, after everything's said and done, there's a 15% fee. We'll just say I made $45, because that is including the cost of the game and the shipping and fees. That's what it's going to be about. I paid $2 for this game, $1.75 or $2. I bought it in a lot of games on eBay. Now, I did this one pretty much right. I didn't make really any mistakes. I believe I priced it correctly. $60 is great for a handheld game. There was no other FBA offer, so I went high and got the buy box. This was an example of, in my opinion, a well-done sale where I do not think I could have squeezed out any more money without waiting until Q4, which I would not want to do that. Give me the $60 now and let me be on my way. Okay, how many times do you see bullshit flip cameras, little flip HD cameras, and you go, who wants that trash? It's not the best quality video with cell phones, with the litany of new cameras coming out every year. Why would you want this old 8 GB flip camera? I don't know why. It's portable, you know, good to give to a kid. Whatever it is, I sold this in about 5 days for $90. I paid $5 for it, and I got $90 for it. You know, after shipping and fees, let's say I got $75 for it. You know, after the cost, $70 profit in 5 days on the low end, probably. 65 low end. The point I'm trying to make is these flip cameras, what you want to do is if you're ungated for them, which I think you should be. I haven't heard about Flip being a very litigious brand, but go on eBay and just look for these and buy them for $15. Same thing with Sony Walkmans, same thing with a lot of stuff, but these flip cameras are a serious bolo. Be on the lookout for these flip cameras. There's an 8 GB model and a 16 GB model. There may be a 4 GB, I'm not sure, but this one, it's actually the Ultra HD model. Excuse me. Ultra HD. So your flip cam is shooting in the same quality as Star Wars, whatever the hell the last movie was. Totally the same. That's why it sold for $90, clearly. And the last one is an especially odd one because it's the kind of thing I would not recommend you selling. It's a fish finder, a hummingbird fish finder, and the reason you shouldn't sell these is the same reason, not the same reason, but a similar reason as to why I had to refund the guy $40. He bought it for $135 from me after about 2 months, and then I had to refund $40 because it didn't have the mounting kit, right? They don't sell them with the mounting kit. It isn't part of the picture on Amazon, but with these fish finders, either they've been installed incorrectly, or they were attempted to be installed, and the person who took it to a thrift store left some parts out. Things along that line, they're just very finicky. Now this one, the reason I bought it and sold it is because the wiring was still in its protective plastic wrap. It had never been installed, but still it was missing something, and luckily it wasn't advertised in the listing, so the guy said, hey, where's my mounting rack? And I said, what are you talking about? And he said, well, I'm going to have to return it. And I said, okay, here's $40. Like, buy yourself a new one. Did he scam me? Maybe. I don't know. Maybe he wanted a refund. Who knows? But from my perspective, that $40 is way better than it being sent back to me, it being inspected and saying, oh, seller said it was defective. Mail it back to you. Paying $6 or $8 or whatever it is to have it, you know, removed and sent back to me. Looking at it again, prepping it again, resending it in. I mean, probably I would have to pay $15 in fees. You know, fees being the return shipping stuff and shipping it back to Amazon. Not fees like on a line item Amazon chart, but just expenses. And then I have to worry about it selling again. And so, in my opinion, yeah, the $40, I didn't win, you know, that battle, per se. But I definitely am still alive in the war. All right, guys, that was the video. Did you like it? Please subscribe. Leave a comment of your best find of the week. And tell me, what kind of videos do you like? I made some awesome coin roll hunting videos I think are very fun. I'm working on some videos about how to sell rocks. Rocks from the earth. You can just sell them for money. That's the kind of stuff I want to help you understand, because if you make more money, everything works out. All right, guys, see you later. We'll be right back.